In this second part of the trakKutter video, I'm going to show you some of the cool new features when editing videos and photos in the trakKutter. Firstly, we'll show you how to make a selection. Making a selection to edit from video or photo files works the same for audio. Holding the Shift key on your keyboard while holding down the left mouse button and drag. Just to note, when video and photos are in the trakKutter, the Snap to Grid feature is turned off, allowing for more precise editing of your media clip. Also, an important feature is, if your video file also contains audio, you can select either the audio and video individually, or select them together. This gives you complete control over what you want to edit. You can also adjust the length of this box using the adjust length indicators. When a video is placed in the trakKutter, you'll notice a preview window will appear. This preview window shows the video, and if you've created a selection box, it'll only display what is in the box. I'll click play to preview the video in the selection box.
Oh, lovely, show me the medal.
And I'll click stop. To remove a selection box, simply left click anywhere outside the box. With the introduction of the new audio and video scrubbing feature, it is now possible to do precision editing with the play bar. So I'll just quickly set up a new selection, and now I'm going to tighten up the box to get my precision cut. I will use the scrubbing feature along with the preview window to position the play cursor where I want the edit to start. I can also use the scroll wheel on my mouse to zoom in and out for greater accuracy. Once I'm happy with my starting point, right click in the selection box and select Snap Start to Play Cursor. To create an endpoint, I will again position my play cursor, right click and select Snap End to Play Cursor. I will now click play to preview my edit.
Show me Libby! Oh lovely, show me the medal! Show me Libby!
And I'll press stop.
Oh lovely, show me the medal!
I can also grab the play cursor to scroll through it quickly. Once I'm happy with my selection, I can right click on it, select copy, and then right click and paste where I would like it to be placed in the mixing screen. The edited file is now in the mixing screen. Okay, let's go back to the trakKutter and I'll briefly discuss the loop region. When a loop region is created, the video will only preview in that region. To create a loop region, right click on the ruler where you'd like it to start and select Loop Start. Then right click on the ruler again where you'd like it to end and select Loop Stop. I'll click play to preview. You can also create a loop region quickly by double clicking on the ruler and adjusting the length of the yellow bar with your mouse. If I right click on the loop region, I can create a selection or copy the file within the loop region. To remove the loop region, simply select Remove the Loop Region or click on it and press Delete on your keyboard. So now we'll move on and discuss the preview window. If you'd like to adjust the size of the window, move your mouse to the side of the window and the adjust length indicators will appear, and I can adjust accordingly. So now I'll show you some of the new features we've introduced. These features include the Rotate Path, Anti-clockwise by 90 degrees, Clockwise by 90 degrees, Invert Vertically, and Invert Horizontally. We've also introduced the ability to zoom in and out of your video or photo. And you can do this two ways. Firstly, you can use the zoom slider to zoom in and out. We've also introduced some presets which can be accessed by right-clicking on the zoom slider and selecting the options from the drop-down menu. These presets are extremely useful if you want to create a collage or split screen in the mixing window and be confident they are the same size. This is covered in greater detail in the collaging video. But here I'll give a brief example. I can tap between my two videos in the trakKutter and I'll set my two videos to half size and position them to give a split screen effect. When I'm happy, I can copy them and paste them into the mixing screen. And now press play. The second way to zoom in and out is to right click on the preview window and select either zoom in and out. I can then use the left mouse button to control the zoom. To move the video or photo to other areas within the preview window, I can use the horizontal offset and vertical offset. For precision movement, click on the offset once and use the direction buttons on your keyboard. You can also move the image around the preview window by right-clicking on the screen and selecting Grab. To restore the offsets to their original position, right-click on them and select Restore to Default. You'll notice when you use the zoom and offsets in the trakKutter, you will see a blue border. This border represents the frame dimensions of the original file. To restore the image to its normal default state, click on the restore icon in the preview window. Another reason why these controls are so useful is, for example, if you have a photo that is taken vertically with your camera and needs to be adjusted, I can simply click on the clockwise icon. So now again I'll give a brief example of how these features can make your mix exciting and fun. I can use rotate, zooms, and the offsets to edit the image to my liking. And when happy, I can copy and paste it into the mixing screen. I can also introduce some quick fades. Again, to learn more about collaging, please view the collaging video. So finally, let's look at some of the other controls in the trakKutter. You have the reverse play button, which plays your video in reverse. The tempo pot, which will speed up or slow down the play rate of your video. You can click on the Restore Tempo button to restore the video to its normal play rate. You can zoom in and out of specific areas using the mouse scroll wheel or the zoom in and out icons in the bottom left-hand corner of the trakKutter. Also, by clicking on the mouse wheel, we'll bring up the scroll tool, allowing you to scroll through your file quickly, or else use the scroll bar on the bottom. You can also adjust and boost the volume and video brightness by moving the sliders and right-clicking on them to boost. Video brightness will simply increase or decrease the brightness of your video or photo. If you wish to export or convert your video file, or a selection of audio, video, or both, click on the Export button. The Save Media To dialog box will appear. Here you can save or convert your media to different file formats, such as MP4, WMV, or AVI. You can also convert your file to popular play devices, such as iPhone, iPod, and PSP.